Hi, I'm Tristy. I've been getting a lot of questions in the last couple of weeks from people asking me about how they can get started using Angular's Material Design Package. So I thought it would be really cool to spend a couple of minutes and just take you through that process. I'm just about to create a new app. I thought this is a perfect time to do that. So if you're not familiar with Angular's Material Design, if you jump across to material.angularjs.org. You can check out the website. There's a little video on here as well. I'll jump across to the demos and you can get a bit of a feel for what material design is all about. So the idea is, I guess, to involve the user in the interactions that they're having with your app, particularly for touchscreen type devices. So if you have a look at the checkbox, got this nice little kind of ripples that that indicate that you've actually kind of interacted with it. There's quite a few cool little bits and pieces. One of my favorites are these inputs. So the inputs kind of let you put something in there and they sort of change around as you just go and add data to the field. So it's actually quite quite interactive, quite fun for the users to have a bit of a play with. So how do you actually get started? Well, it's actually very, very simple. And I'll go ahead and show you how to do that. So I'm just going to jump across to my bower.json file. And I actually have Angular Material in my bower.json file. If you don't, I'll show you how to actually get that in there. But before you do that, one of the things that you need to make sure you do is have Angular 1.3 or above in order to use the Angular Material package. So to install Angular Material, we just need to open up a terminal, and in here you can just type in bower. Now if you don't have WebStorm and you don't want to use a terminal, you can just go into any command line utilities such as command prompt or PowerShell or something like that. So we want to do bower install, and it's just Angular Material. So that's all you need to do. Now, if you want it to automatically be added to your bower.json file once you have installed it, you can just add just a space and then minus minus save. On the end there. For some reason the E has disappeared off the end of save, but it should be S-A-V-E. I'll try that again. Nope, doesn't like it. So it should be save. And so just throw that in there. That should then go ahead and install it for you. I've actually got it installed. So what I'm going to do is just go through and just update to give you a bit of feel for what we need to do. So let that happen. Cool, that was nasty quick. I do actually have it installed previously, so that's kind of what you should end up with. You know it's done once the command prompt has returned back to you. Cool, so now that we've got it installed, we need to actually reference the packages that we've installed. So we can have a quick look at it. So jump to public and down to live. I'm just gonna make that smaller so you can see it. And Angular Material is the package that we've got, but there's a few other packages that come installed with it, such as angular-aria. So that wouldn't have been in your initial files. That's been installed as part of Angular Material. What we need is the CSS file, the JS file, and we also need to grab the JS file from angular-aria as well. So pretty straightforward, but there's just a little trick to how you actually make sure that the packages are installed in a particular order so that they can work for you. So jump up to config, let's go to assets, and we're going to go across to default. And I'm just going to pop down again to Angular Material. So we want to reference the CSS here. Quick shortcut when you're using WebStorm, just right click on copy reference, and just put in a comma, jump to the next line. Single quotes, and that's your CSS done. So now we've referred to that. The next thing we need to do is just go up to your Angular Aria package, just grab a reference to that one, and we want to put that one just after AngularJS. So plug that in there and just make sure you got a comma on the end. And then the next one is Angular Material, the JavaScript file for that. Again, as I've sort of, if you've gone through any of my previous videos, you'll know that when we're looking at default, we've got the actual CSS and JavaScript files going in here. The minified versions go into your production assets. Okay, so to put the Angular Material JavaScript file in, we're going to plug that one after animate. So just pop that down there. Again, make sure you got a comma on the end. So now we've got references to those three files. They're the key ones that we're going to need. All right, next step is to actually add a reference to the module so that Angular knows that there's a module there once the files are available for it. So to do that, I'm just going to close the config, close public as well. Jump down to modules. We're going to go to core and across to client, go to app and config. And here are our dependencies as we've sort of come across before. What we're going to do is add ngMaterial to the end here. So it's just single quotes, and within that, you just want to put in ng and then material with a capital M. Let's scroll across so you can see that. Like that. So just ng material with a capital M. Great. So now that we've got that, so we've got the package, we've put in the references to the particular files we'll need. We've told Angular that we need to load the particular dependencies part of initiating Angular. And now there's sort of a couple more things that I'll show you that'll come in handy for you. Go across, just down to server, and we'll go down to views, and just open the layout view. We've got this line 15 here, which refers to the viewport. What we're going to do is just after that equals one, put in a little comma and just put in user and scalable. And we just make that equal no. And what that'll do is just help reduce the latency for when we're using our app on touchscreen devices. So there's usually like a 300 millisecond delay. So that should help fix that up. All right, now while we're here, wouldn't it be cool if we could actually bring in parts of Angular Material and use it in our app? So before I do that, I'm just going to load up the app to show you what I've currently got. So I'll just jump into Gulp and just get that up and running. Cool. So let's have a look at the app. So I'll just refresh that. Cool. So here's our current app. We've got this default kind of black bootstrap kind of header at the top. Let's have a look at what Angular Material provides to us, and let's see how we actually set our app up to use that. So I'll jump over to demos, jump down to toolbar. So toolbar's the bar at the top. And let's say we wanted to introduce something like this. So it's sort of blue and it's got this little shadow if you look closely underneath the toolbar there. So to add that, this is sort of the code that we need. So I'm going to make that a little bit smaller, bring it over here to the side like that, and just pop up WebStorm over here. So luckily, or thankfully enough, I'm actually already in the layout server view. So this is where I can update the header. So at the moment, when we set up the app, we have a body which sets up the header, and then it goes and finds the content, which is the rest of the Angular app. Around all of this, I'm going to plug in. So if you weren't sure what I'm doing, I'll just show you what I'm actually trying to do here. So if I go down to layout and just have a look at the grid system, or actually just even the container elements, gives you a bit of an idea about what we've got to play with. We've got rows and columns for layouts. We're using the Flexbox kind of system here. So what I'm going to do is put in here div layout equals column, because I want this to be a column layout. And I'm going to do layout fill. So, and then within that, what I'm going to do is just jump back to the demo and the toolbar so you can see what I'm looking at. And what we're going to do is just put in the MD toolbar reference here. So I'm going to plug that in here and the closing tag there. Just align that together. And then I'm going to grab the header and paste that in between these two tags. Let's make that a little bit bigger so you can see it. The other thing that I'm going to do is remove what's currently in that class, because this is a bootstrap class at the moment, and I'm going to change that up here, which is MD toolbar tool. So I'll copy that, paste that in there. So that will give me the top part, but that won't give me the content bit at the bottom. So to do that, what I'm going to do is this time I'm going to do MD content, because I actually want sort of scroll all the way around this content. And within that, I'm just going to put, oops, up here, a little bit of padding. So I just get a class MD padding, just like that. And now what I can do is copy this bit. I don't want any of the other bits. I just want that, which will help us load up our app and bring it up like that. So it's got to look something like this. So we've got a div layout, which equals column, which gives us the columns from the grids that we had a quick look at before. We've got MD toolbar, which then encapsulates our header. And our header has a class of MD toolbar tools. And then underneath that, we've got MD content with a class of MD padding. And that is where I'm going to leave that. So hopefully that's not too much or too scary, but let me save that up and show you what that'll do for us. So I'll just jump across to our app. And there you go. So now I have a nice bright blue header, and I've got that nice gentle kind of shadow just underneath that, which kind of gives us that material design kind of feel. So I hope that helped. Please subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Check out bossable.com for more details. Let me know if you've got questions that I can help you out with, and I'll see you again really soon.